Every day that I wake up in my bunk, I count my blessings to the first attention, the siren of the stars.
Every day, oh, I like to talk about the stuff. Oh, talky.
This is one I've tried.
Oh yeah, this is that. Talky. Where is the engineer's area? I was waiting for the air to come back also.
It's getting a crack at all of the leftovers from the dining area buffet.
Please shut up. Oh, these people.
You're a guest of Captain Rokoff, right? Welcome aboard.
Thank you. Yeah, I've been in here. Oops. Ballroom. But isn't it ballroom but the engineer's on the way? No.
Please remain in designated passenger areas at all times. Have a safe journey.
I know, guys. I don't know where I'm going.
The ship's purser.
It doesn't help that we've lost. I mean, this just tells me to go back to my ship, and we don't have the little arrows showing us where to go. That goes up to more crew quarters. I'm just trying to get out of here and then over to where we're supposed to be going. Well, here's the purser again. Holbrook claim ID. Okay, so what I need to do then, I need to pull the alarm and I need to make my way to Holbrook. I mean, Gabriel's good too. Right? There's Vera. The purser's right here. Next two, right? Two. And then one is who? We don't have one.
You've already ruined our scheme. What else do you want?
I'm walking around, lady. Crew quarter. And then this is what? Up to the ballroom again? It's up to the top floor quarters. Swist is one. Oh, so it is the top floor. Vera, Gabriel. That's the ballroom. Yeah, it's ridiculous that I can't breathe. I'm just walking around in a place with a normal atmosphere. Three is, oh, I guess, yeah, under construction. Holbrook. Need to make our way here to four. That's most important. Then we can get the claim ID from her. Now we just gotta find out where the engineer's section is. I know it's up like a long set of stairs, but I don't know where those stairs are. Laundry services again. Alright, so we have to go down. Ballroom. That's the thing. I don't know where the engineer section is. I'm pretty sure it's that guy with the stutter. Purser. Yep. That's exactly where I have to go. But after somewhere else. Just keep hitting back here. What's wrong with me? Is that this is like a closed off section. Right? I think the only way in or out of here is through here. So we have to go through here. I mean, maybe I'm wrong. We have to go through the ballroom and out another way.
In the event of a locked tower, remember to return to your cabin in a quiet and orderly fashion.
I'll be returning to everyone else's cabin, thank you. Alright, so this is one way in. And it's giving me the indicator, but it's been leading me back to my ship, and that's not where we want to go. So, this way then.
Don't forget to keep your Starview pass handy at all times.
Oh, but I've been through here as well. Crew quarters? Crew quarters. Not passenger. So I have to go from crew quarters to passenger. I'm pretty sure it's through crew quarters. You're not the one I need to talk to, right?
Listen.
Nope.
Can't hear the engines.
I'm not gonna listen to your engines. Okay. Whoops.
These newer vessels, more or less run autonomously. Which doesn't make much of a
I don't need to see any quarters.
Captain Lokov is one of the most easygoing CEOs I've ever worked under. In fact, he doesn't act much like a captain at all. There's nothing quite like the view from the
sky. How about up here? Damn it. No, I don't want to go back here. How do I get up? It ain't frustrating just finding my way around here. Okay, all these people. This is inaccessible. Can't go through here. And I came from there, right?
Troy must have spent a fortune equipping
so
the ship with triple redundancy in almost every
instance. Where the hell is the engineering section? I'm finding it impossible to find anything in here.
Shh,
no, I remember this. Yeah, mission. What about this? That's back to the ballroom once again. Where have I not gone?
These newer vessels. More or less run the colors.
Yeah, all these people. Please get out of my way. Yep, I can't avoid this area. So
every
is it
day that I wake up in my bunk,
is it off of here? The engineering? Not in there. Inaccessible. Maybe that's the bathroom. Just waiting for that to go away. Do you want some things?
To Venus?
No. Nope.
Want to see what I'm carrying?
Nope. We need to go into our stuff. I want inventory. Sarah's inventory. How do I give her things? Trade gear.
I'll only...
Okay, I don't want to take anything. Okay, I guess... Is this her stuff? This doesn't look like my inventory. Oh, maybe it is. Take the gun. Yeah, that's okay. Maybe they won't take it back from you. This way I can run around quicker. Peril. Okay. Take this stuff. I could just drop the bell. I just took that to be funny. Thank you.
And goodbye. Thank you.
Goodbye, then. Jeez. Drop. Ding. All right. On. Right, this is where we come in. And she knew not to follow me. You're going the wrong way. Okay, so off of here.
Between you and me.
Restroom.
The best part of my job is getting a crack on.
Best part of my job is finding.
Captain Rokoff is one of the most easygoing CEOs I've ever worked under. In fact, he doesn't act much like a captain at all.
Huh. Yeah, what's a deployment deck? Like, I don't know if that's something we can interact with, like read their deployment instructions or something. I don't know what that is. It's gotta be around here, you know. I've
Trident must have spent a fortune equipping the ship.
Yeah, I know these are all just rooms. Don't look at me.
Hey. That isn't yours.
Shh. What's a boudica? Forgive me. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing that. That's all we need to do? You steal a med pack and you fail the mission? Sorry guys. I know that was cheesy. I should have run with it. But I've been trying so hard just to find this place.
This is one of Trident's
engineering. I was there twice before. You figure I could just like
you're a guest of
go
Captain
back
Rokoff,
there?
Right? Welcome aboard.
Stop talking to me. I do not like you.
Captain Rokoff said.
Yeah, yeah, Captain Rokoff. Are you? I thought she was walking it. You're taking the thing for a walk? So that's the bathroom. So there's really nowhere to go from this, and this is where we came in. So, like, the This is just crazy to me. I guess we have to go... That's inaccessible. We have to go through here. And up. Right, and then what's up here? Just more of this. I would sell my soul for like a blueprint of this place. Just a map or something. All we have up here are these... Yeah, we got laundry. And we've got these cabins. Right, and then you go back down. And you've got the ballroom here. And along here, you've got other cabins, and we've got the safe that we want to get into. Right, she's over there. Alright, but there's nothing available. There's nowhere else to go. Do we have to go through the ballroom? Because I thought there were only... Yeah, and here's the purser. Right. So once we actually pull the alarm, we want to get down here. We want to get to up to 3, I believe it is. Get her thing and then head to the purser. Crew quarters. Right? More crew quarters. So we're not going that way. And then, but this is back the way we came, right? Nothing along here either. This is where we came in.
Quite like the view from the start.
Inaccessible.
It's breathtaking.
I mean, I could try to follow this. It's just leading me back to my ship, though. And these people just talk way too much. This is... It's down there, so I'm gonna cut through the ballroom and see what we can do. Because I'm not familiar with the layout of this place, and I can't just look at it. There's no map. I don't know why they did that. Someone please install a mod that has maps for everything. And just hit M for map, and we'll know we can see everything. It wants us to go through this way. So we will try to go through this way. So now it wants us to go where exactly? Down. Okay, so this is down a little bit. But not enough. It looks like it wants us in the ballroom. But you go in there and it tells you to leave. I'm not sure. What is going on? Burden of proof. Failure to communicate. Trying to see if there's another miscellaneous quest in here that I can choose or actually lead me somewhere good. Dennis has asked me to equip deserted robotics lab. Okay, that's not it. What about activities? What kind of activities do we have? No. Old neighborhood. Yeah, I look forward to doing all of these, but... Not right now. Show only active targets. Would that help? Show only active targets? Now it'll show me where I really need to go? Maybe that's it? It's telling me to go back in the ballroom again. Alright, so we go into the ballroom.
I've done this particular restaurant several times, and I can assure you...
I don't care what you've done. It's telling me down.
Here for business or pleasure?
Both.
I certainly hope they decide to hold all future society events aboard a Starliner.
Engineering deck. E- engineering deck is off the ballroom. Good to know. That's the thing, I had all targets selected, I guess. So we run back into the ballroom and then head through and then back into the passenger quarters. And then up to the very top. I mean, assuming I only have a certain amount of time. Because then after that, people are going to be heading to their quarters, so I'm going to encounter them. Aren't I? Mess with them. Alright, we're gonna mess with them.
Hold up. This area is off limits to passengers.
I'm not
Wait
a passenger.
Wait a second. You're Captain Rockoff's guest, right? Didn't expect to see you down here. Sorry to give you trouble. What can I do for you?
So what are you doing, Rand? What do you do around here?
I'm the Siren's chief engineer. Trident put me in charge of the entire tech team. We do our best to keep the ship running smoothly and efficiently. Of course, this beauty is a cutting-edge piece of spacecraft design. Almost everything has triple redundancy, like the life support system. Unfortunately, that means there's quite a bit of downtime. Could be worse, though, right?
Kind of lonely down here, isn't it?
Yeah, a little. A few of the techs call this deck the dungeon. I think you can see why. Not exactly Starliner class comfort down here. Don't get me wrong. The quiet gives me time to gather my thoughts, catch up on work, and all that. But I'd rather work on the bridge.
Well, I really need to get into the life support area.
Sorry. That area's off limits. No exceptions.
An exception this time. Ha. I'm the captain's guest, but you can't let me into that room? I know, Captain Rokov said.
No, sorry. I'm afraid it's impossible. Trident regulations strictly prohibit anyone from entering the life support area without a valid reason. Look, I'm not trying to be a jerk here. It's just that I could lose my job, you know?
Your job? Captain Rokov said he's willing to forgive your gambling debt.
Oh, really? Well, that changes things quite a bit.
Money talks.
Tell you what, I'm just going to step out for a bit and stretch my legs.
There you go.
Maybe you can hold this for me while I'm away.
What am I holding? Gain entry. What do you think of Captain Rokov?
Honestly, he's a seasoned ship captain. He told me he was a long hauler for years and the experience shows. Only thing is, he's always talking about trade deals and plans for get-rich-quick schemes. It's all the guy ever thinks about. Why he decided to be a Starliner captain, I'll never know. It's almost like he craves being around money. Tell you what, though, for someone that loves credit so much, he sure doesn't mind gambling them when we play cards.
So what's your role here?
I'm the Siren's chief engineer. Trident put me in charge of the entire tech team. We do our best to keep the ship running smoothly and efficiently. Of course, this beauty is a cutting-edge piece of spacecraft design. Almost everything has triple redundancy, like the life support system.
Right.
Unfortunately, that means there's quite a bit of downtime. Could be worse, though, right?
Alright, so I've already asked him that.
Whatever you do, don't break anything, or I'll be out of a job.
Oh, he gave me his ID. Be out of a job. Run! Run! Run, you fool! Emergency procedures. I'll just look through this. Trident Operations Manual. SOTS. -02-020.40. In the event of an Alpha LSU-01 life support failure, Beta LSU-02 will automatically activate. In the highly unlikely event that Beta LSU-02 has failed, Gamma LSU-03 will automatically activate. If a catastrophic failure has occurred and all three units are offline, an automatic order to deploy environment suits will be broadcast throughout the ship. Please contact the chief engineer on duty for further details or refer to Section 30 in the Trident Operations Manual. Trident Operations Manual, etc. If any life support fails, an automated emergency lockdown procedure will be placed immediately into effect. All passengers will be ordered to calmly proceed to their cabins until such time as the captain of the ship deems the emergency to be resolved. If the captain has been incapacitated, please recognize the proper chain of command as per Trident Operations Manual. In addition, all interior door lock mechanisms for passenger cabins and all mustering areas will be set to unlocked to allow for uninhibited crew access. Emergency lighting and audio announcements will remain in effect for the duration of the event. Alright, life support access. Open. For safety reasons, life support access cannot be sealed without approval from the chief engineer on duty. See the Trident Manual for details. And we're in business. Anything else good in here? Which one am I supposed to hit? All of them? I thought it was just one. Centimete turkey. Rokov suggested that I coax Gabriel Vera into his cabin by sabotaging the Starliner's life support sensors. Then I should be able to confront him in private. I should then proceed to that section of the ship. Vera's on the lower floor. So I gotta go get the award ID. And see what else we can do. And then head for the lower floor. And get into the safe or vault or whatever, and then talk to him. Disable the life support completely? And that's the thing. I mean, it's just what hit just one of these. So am I defeating the triple redundancy? I don't want to completely defeat it and be responsible for killing people. Quick save, right before the moment of action here.
All passengers, may I have your attention, please? The captain has declared a ship-wide emergency. Please report to your cabins in an orderly fashion, and remain there until you receive further instructions.
I think I know where to go.
Well, it appears that we've definitely ruined the party. Everyone's gone.
I need to leave. Hold up. They're all going to be in their rooms. Can't move. Okay.
All passengers are being asked to return to their cabin.
I'm running to my cabin.
Siren of the Stars is now in emergency status. Please remain calm and proceed to your cabin.
I need to go up higher. Second. This is the higher one, isn't it? Wait a second. Sheila Holbrook. Oh wait, I can... Due to the current emergency, the door's locking mechanism has been disabled. Is she here? Can I close it again? No? Oh. She is here. What we got? Story of the Heavens. Huh. Yeah, I'll read it really quick. Ever since Neil Armstrong first set foot on the moon in 1969, humanity has been obsessed with the idea of permanently breaking free from the confines of Earth's gravity. Not just visiting other planets, but settling them, truly living among the stars. But in the mid-20th century, that dream proved short-lived. The Apollo 17 mission in 1972 was the last time humans set foot on the moon, and for several decades afterward, NASA's mission seemed to focus on orbital space shuttle flights and unmanned reconnaissance. The dream of galactic exploration, while not exactly dead, was definitely sitting on the back of a dusty shelf. And then, in the year 2016, everything changed. Or did it? A team of scientists announced that they had actually detected, for the first time, the gravitational waves Albert Einstein proposed a century earlier in his general theory of relativity. Scientific postulating, even great scientific postulating by one of humanity's greatest minds, was still just so many formulas on paper. But the discovery of gravitational waves changed all that. Theory became reality, and that reality fostered renewed hope in humanity's ability to understand and manipulate space-time. And more importantly, it rekindled the great dream of space exploration and expansion. Of course, even after the discovery of gravitational waves, there was still much work to be done. Humanity had not yet even traveled beyond Earth's planetary system, so that was the first goal, one that was accomplished when humans first set foot on Mars in the year 2050. Cool. I'll probably be alive to see that. Not too far away. Just another 26 years, yeah, that's all. My friend will be. Can I access the computer? Okay, no. I'm looking for...
All passengers, may I have your attention, please? The captain has declared a ship-wide emergency.
Please don't be doing stuff
like that.
Please report to your
captains in an orderly fashion and remain there until you receive further instructions.
I'll take the wooden puzzle box. So, where would she put this code? Does it involve me? Someone's walking. That's her down there. Maybe I have to get it from her specifically. I took her suit and her green fashionable suit. Operator leatherwear. Reminder, safety drill soon. Just seeing if it's like written down somewhere. I hope it's not in the safe. Room cleaning service 9 a.m. to 11. This I can't get in the safe, and these can't be opened. And then. After sabotaging the life support sensors, I've tripped the Starliner's lockdown mode. All of the passengers should be sequestered in their passenger cabins. I can now confront Gabriel Vera out of the public's view. I know she's sitting right over there. I probably gotta talk to her about it. Soil box. I'm making all this noise.
All passengers, may I have your attention, please? The captain has declared a ship-wide emergency.
I'm taking these outfits.
Please report to your captains in an orderly fashion. And remain there until you receive further instructions.
Better think about what you're taking.
It's a med pack. Med packs are good. So are zipper bandages. I don't think I've ever had them before, though. They got naked mannequins. Yeah, you better get out.
Excuse me. Would you mind telling me exactly what the hell you're doing in my cabin?